Today we will discuss about light and photosynthesis, which is most important. So Priestley, when he was doing about a well jar experiment, the team was not confirmed about the energy, how the energy is required for the photosynthesis here. But in later stages here, how energy was supplied to the plant and how the energy is used by the plant was discovered by later scientists. And this was made here, how the energy is supplying for the plant means it absorbs, every plant will just absorb the water from the soil, and also it will be absorbing a sufficient amount of carbon dioxide. But in general, if energy is supplied, what will happen here? Carbon dioxide and water, these two elements, if energy is supplied, then what will happen? It is producing oxygen, carbon and hydrogen. That is what we are calling it as hydrocarbons. That means here carbohydrates. So these are the materials which are formed from the two elements when energy is supplied. This is what we will see in case of photosynthesis. Small x, simple organic molecules are converting into very complex organic molecules. So here complex molecules will be formed. But scientists understood that if these are supplied with energy, these are formed. Then what is about the reverse? If these are supplied with energy, can these will be formed? So this was not understood by Priestley's time, whether forming of different components. Later, scientists also successful with carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. When it is supplied with energy, then the things will be forming. So that was made important here. This was later concluded. Usually, water plus carbon dioxide, if it is supplied with energy, then what will happen? There are the different products formed. But here scientists also passed and were confirmed that when carbon, hydrogen and oxygen are supplied with energy, then the same important components will be formed. So same thing observed, that carbon dioxide plus water, when it is supplied with energy, carbohydrates are forming. So what is the reverse here? When carbon, hydrogen, oxygen is supplied with same energy, then whether oxygen or water is formed or carbon dioxide is formed, when this is forming here, how do they get the energy in reverse form? This was the question for many scientists. But later a Dutch scientist here, his name known as John Ingenoss. His name is known as Jan Ingenoss here. He belongs to 17th century, and he found the answer. What he studied, that means here, plants usually will be producing oxygen. This will be only in presence of light. This he was observed very clearly. Sunlight is present means oxygen will be present. So this was he keenly observed in an aquatic plant here. So he brought an aquatic plant, you know, many plant, aquatic plants will be there. Many aquatic plants will be there here. Usually he has seen that he kept an aquatic plant in the water and he just kept under sunlight. Then after that he observed that bubbles are forming. So these bubbles, he understood that definitely these belongs to some oxygen bubbles. So why? Because in the presence of sunlight, every plant will produce oxygen. So this made a great advantage for his new scientific experiments, so that only he can able to make hydrilla experiment. So that he concluded that here oxygen is produced in aquatic plants when same energy sunlight is produced here. Same plants, if it is in aquatic condition, that means in water, oceans, so what will happen? They produce same oxygen in the form of bubbles, we will see. Then Ingenoss has found that the bubbles which are formed in an aquatic plant when kept in a beaker in the presence of sunlight, the bubbles consist of oxygen. This was later proved. And one more scientist was there. His name was Engelmann. Engelmann in 20th century here, he noticed that a maximum rate of photosynthesis also in that experiments. Maximum rate of photosynthesis is always said that where a good carbon dioxide is present, where good sunlight is present, where good water is present and good chlorophyll is present, at that time maximum rate of photosynthesis is seen. And this Engelmann, he made algae. Usually in older taps here greenish material you can see, so that greenish material is called as algae. So he taken a scale sized algae strip and he passed some light light onto that thing. That means here on the algae, he passed the light, which is most important. Then what happened here? Red and blue lights were illuminated. They shined on this. Then what happened here? This made that light effect will be there continuously on algae material. This was given by Angelman, and he belongs to recent century, 20th century here. That means here some bacteria can be living which are photosensitive also. He understood that here algae was a photosensitive one, and which will absorb blue and green, blue and red wavelengths of light. Then he understood that there are different kinds of pigments are present. That means different kinds of cell arrangements are present in every plant and leaf. So that will absorb different kinds of light, like blue, green, red, different kind of things. And these pigments are responsible to trapping sunlight energy. This was explained by the so-called scientist Angelman and Jan Ingenaus.